This work, Mawson, is one of a series of 8 lithographs owned by the TMAG and is based on a summer trip that artist Jan Senbergs took to the Antarctic in 1987. Senbergs was born in Latvia in 1939 and fled across the snow in a horse and cart with his mother and siblings to avoid the same fate as his father, who was killed by advancing armies. After experiencing a series of migrant camps, he finally arrived in Melbourne to attend technical school until he found an art-related job with a screen printer. His early peripatetic life experience had given him a keen eye for observation. He knew he wanted to be an artist from an early age. Not keen on attending an art school, he was self-taught, drawing and painting when he could, and was not part of any particular art movement. He proceeded to work assiduously, entering art competitions and applying for many artist-in-residence positions along the east coast of Australia. This trail of new experiences and locations fed his interest in place, giving him a special visual vocabulary for the recording of human experience therein. This voyage with the Samaranare team to the Antarctic fed this interest. He wrote that, as grand and sublime as the Antarctic is, he was really more interested in the human aspect, the history that was spread out before his eyes, and the scope for his imagination. He felt that they were there, squatting on the edge of another continent, bringing our cultural baggage with us. This semi-bird's eye view depicts the Australian-based Mawson, named after early explorer Sir Douglas Mawson, as it was in 1987. He gives us a quasi-historical view of the growth of the settlement from the 1950s donga huts in the old quarter up the hill to the more recent fiberglass and metal modules that serve as hospital and living quarters. Senbergs feels that this historical view records evidence of the type of society and place and events which have shaped what he sees and, more importantly, what he feels may have gone on as he imagines it. The lower half of the image is certainly a myriad of organic marks, giving the viewer a sense of activity and settlement around the central icon anchored in the bay, the motor vessel Iceberg. For those of us who live in Hobart, we know that this boat is bright orange for visibility in icy seas. It was often anchored in our port, so we can bring this extra information to the viewing experience. There is an intensity of line work here which contrasts well with the endless space of ice, plateau, horizon and sky in the upper half of the work. But it's the evidence of man's activity that really interests him. In fact, Senbergs has become well known for his gritty urban observations, whether it be at Mount Lyell in Tasmania, Sydney, Ballarat, Wollongong or Port Melbourne. Without the constraints of the influence of particular painting styles, Senbergs developed a distinctive way of depicting settlement as an aerial map, constructing as much from his imagination as reality. He seems to enjoy the distortions of scale, entrapping the viewer in this labyrinth of lines and shapes. Always avoiding literal depictions, Senbergs captures our interests because the organic lines give the eye plenty of encouragement to enter the scene and trace a journey, even if there are cul-de-sacs. For us, it probably does not matter that some of the buildings and roads do not actually exist in this location. He uses the Italian term capriccio to describe and emphasise the gap between his constructed imaginative scenes and the accuracy of the cartographer. Does he succeed in giving the viewer of this work a feeling of frenetic energy? The intensity of line work certainly helps us understand that in this icy wasteland, subject to squall and storms, scientists must hurry to accomplish their tasks in this compact setting. This tight conglomeration of roads and buildings almost threatened to tumble out of the picture plane toward us. This work is a lithograph, a type of printmaking drawn with greasy crayons onto lithographic stones that come from Bavaria in Germany. It is a process that truly reflects the artist's drawn mark. What and how you draw is what you get after printing. Like many busy artists, Senbergs did not actually do the actual printing himself. Instead, he employed Melbourne-based master printer John Robinson. He would have taken his sketchbooks and photos from his Antarctic adventure to the studio, where he would have drawn directly onto the prepared stones. Robinson would have then set about printing an edition of these images matched to the Senberg's original drawing. Senberg's nicely contrasts the black ink of his constructed settlement with the white empty spaces that represent the icy setting. Heavy drawing in the foreground helps the viewer focus on and explore his story before lifting the eyes to the wider context of this majestic and seemingly empty place. This work is primarily about man's activities in the Antarctic and the artist's interests in recording what may have happened as the Mawson base developed. The physical landscape of rocky outcrop and icy plain are support players in this human-centric observation by Jan Senbergs.